I have what it says I have. I can do what it says I can do. Today I will be taught the word of God. I boldly confess, my mind is alert, my heart is receptive. I will never be the same. In Jesus' name, God bless you. I want to talk to you today about make the switch. One prayer we're taught to pray is, God, not my will, but let your will be done. Many times we don't know what's best for us. When it comes to guidance and direction, it's important to ask God to show us his will. God, if it's your will, let me get this position. If it's your will, cause this relationship to move forward. That's honoring God, showing our dependency on him. But there are some things we don't have to pray, God, if it be your will. We can look in the scripture and find out what the will is. When it comes to healing, you don't have to pray, God, if it's your will, you can heal me. All through the scripture, we can see it is God's will. Matthew 15 says, they brought the sick, the lame, the blind to Jesus, and he healed them all. 14 times in the scripture, it says he healed all that were sick. I can't find one time where Jesus turned someone away and wouldn't heal them. He didn't do it the same way, but he healed them all. You don't have to pray, Lord, if it's your will, you can bless me. Jesus said he came that we might live an abundant life, to the full, till it overflows. Well, God, if it's your will, you can free me from this addiction. Otherwise, I'll endure it. I'll take up my cross and follow you. Carrying the cross isn't living addicted, sick, defeated. That means not giving in to carnal desires, not compromising. But as long as you think, God, if it be your will to heal me, to bless me, to free me, it will limit what God does. You have to make the switch from, God, if you want to heal me, to, God, I know you want to heal me. From, God, if you want to bless me, to, God, I know you want to bless me. Well, Joel, if God wants me to carry this sickness, if he wants me to endure it, to show that I trust him, I'll gladly do it. You don't have to carry it. God's already carried it.
Amen.
Isaiah said, Jesus took our infirmities and carried our diseases. It is not faith to say, if it be your will. You have to have the boldness to say, God, I know it is your will. That verse goes on to say, by his stripes you were healed. Jesus took 39 lashes on his back before he was crucified. Studies tell us there are 39 major categories of disease. He took one for each one. He didn't leave anything out. By his stripes you were healed. It's past tense. He's already done it. Our attitude should be, Lord, I receive your healing. I receive what you've already done. You don't have to beg God to do it. Try to talk him into it. Wonder what the will is. Make the switch. God, you carried this sickness, so I don't have to carry it. So, Lord, thank you that healing is flowing into me.
Amen.
Thank you that I'm getting better. Thank you that the number of my days you will fulfill. When the Israelites were in the desert, headed toward the promised land, there were 2 million people out there. They wandered around for 40 years. It says in Psalms, God brought them out, and there was not one sick or feeble one among them. They had been in slavery for years, mistreated. You would think somebody would be sick. Out in the desert, they didn't have pharmacies, hospitals, modern medicine. Surely somebody would have a migraine. Somebody would come down with the flu, with dizziness, with kidney stones, but not one of them were sick. God was showing us his will. Yes, we have to fight illnesses. Things come against us. But if in the back of your mind, you think this sickness must be God's will for me, it must be his plan for my life that will keep you from getting well. God works where there's faith. You have to know it is his will for you to be healthy, whole, and energetic. You may be dealing with an illness. Let me encourage you. It didn't come to stay. It came to pass. It is not permanent. It's temporary. Healing is flowing into you even now. You're getting better as you're listening. The same God that brought them out without one sick or feeble one is in the process of bringing you out right now. One of the names of God in the scripture is Jehovah Rapha. That means the Lord, our healer. You may know God as a savior. That's important, but he wants you to know him as a healer as well. I talked to a man that was diagnosed with Hodgkin's lymphoma. He'd taken different treatments, wasn't having any effect. His doctors were somewhat puzzled. This cancer is treatable. Most people go into remission within 6 months. He was 2 years down the road and not seeing any improvement. He'd had a stem cell transplant, chemotherapy, radiation, nothing was helping. He told how his prayer was, "Lord, if it's my time to die, I'm ready to go. I'll endure it and I'll honor you to the end. But if it be your will, you can heal me." He was waiting to see what God's will was. One night he was flipping through the channels. He heard me talking about how God wants us to be well, how he wants us to live an abundant, victorious life. Something came alive on the inside. Faith was ignited in his heart. Instead of praying, "Lord, if it be your will," he started praying, "Lord, thank you that you have already healed me, that I will live and not die." He prayed from a place of faith, a place of victory. 2 months ago, he went back for a checkup. For the first time in 2 years, he got a clean bill of health. Today, he is 100% cancer-free.
Amen.
Amazing things happen when you make the switch. From God, if it be your will, to God, I know it is your will. That boldness is your faith being released. That's what allows God to bring healing, favor, blessings. And this man loved God. He was ready to endure to the end, to carry that sickness, but he found out he didn't have to carry it. That was the turning point when he made the switch. There's a big difference between praying, "God, if it be your will, you can heal me," to praying, "God, I know it is your will. I know the price has already been paid. I know you're Jehovah Rapha, the Lord my healer. So thank you that healing is flowing into me." It's difficult to have faith if you don't think it's something God wants to do. You have to be convinced it is God's will for you to be healthy. It is his will for you to be blessed, to live an abundant life. When you know this, you'll do like him, and you'll live out of a place of faith, not doubt, not wondering. The scripture tells us to come boldly to the throne to find help in our time of need. It's not boldness to say, "God, if it be your will, you can take away this sickness, this cancer, this chronic pain." That's not coming boldly. That's coming with doubts. That's coming unsure, not knowing if it's supposed to happen. You have to make the switch. Some things we already know are God's will. One of the best things we can do is remind God what he said. If you want to pray with confidence, bring the will to him. Pray what he promised. "God, you said you would restore health back into me. You said you took my infirmities, carried my sicknesses. You said by your stripes I was healed." When you pray the promises, you won't say, "if it be your will," because you know the will. Imagine Jesus sitting at the right hand of the Father. He hears the prayer, "Lord, if it be your will, you can heal me." He turns to the Father and says, "You mean after all the stripes I took, after all the pain I endured, after I sacrificed to carry their sicknesses, they're still wondering if it's my will?" It doesn't honor God to say, "if it be your will." After all God has done,